You guys, bear with me for a second while I just make sure everything is on and working and all that stuff. So, I think... You guys, bear with me for a second while I just make sure everything is...
Sounds like I have sound.
Awesome! I'm going to put on some music. And if anyone pops into the chat, please feel free. Let me know how my voice to music ratio is, you know. It's hard to know. My end. All right, so what we are doing here today is page 3 of Tracy Queen. So I have my script, right? And I did my little thumbnail sketches to kind of work out my composition for the script. Well, let me take this off of autofocus because that's up on JPS. One second. Okay. Should be better, I believe. Yeah, so I have my little mini thumbnail sketches. So page 3, panel 1, picking up from page 2, which I did 3 streams ago. Panel 1 is we're seeing through the window, and we're looking at Tracy still quite distraught, and in the background of the panel, it's just going to be a block of text. It's her having an internal monologue, like rant, about her situation. She's basically like under her grandfather's thumb, and her grandfather is an international like drug kind of organized crime family leader. So anyway, she's like, and she just got broken up with her boyfriend who found out about her involvement and was like, "You're a criminal, like I can't be involved with this," and he booked. So she's like totally bummed. First panel is that. Second panel is her kind of just going from bum to like fury, you know. And she's standing there all strong. In the third panel, like in this, you know, just pissed off mode. And then she hears a thump coming from through her bedroom door, which has a closet door, which has a trap door, which leads to a stairwell that goes to her grandfather's warehouse. That she's basically a front for and kind of protects. So she turns around all spooked and she's like, "What?" And she's like, "Crap, you know, grandfather's gonna kill me. There's someone in the warehouse," and she grabs her sword. So that's the page. You know, the last panel, my little thumbnail sketch wasn't informative enough for me, so I redrew that again just to get like the feeling kind of right. So then from these little sketches over here, I reworked them, you know, a little bit larger. This is at size. This is an actual, like, comic book page size template. So I drew the sketches to get the composition much more detailed and, you know, kind of how I want it. So then I took this and I scanned it in and blue lined it. So that is basically just taking those pencil lines and just making them super, super faint and pure cyan. And I printed that out large. So this is on an 11 by a 17, but it still has a framing in here that is comic book format ratio. I think it's not quite 200%. I think it's like 175. It might be 200. Well, anyway. It's larger. And the purpose of that is now when I draw it again larger, it's going to be way more detailed. And I'll be able to get these lines pretty crisp and, you know, how I want them. And then I will, you know, when I'm done with this week's scan, this week's drawing stream, I will, I'll scan these in and I will make my pencil lines that I do today. Like solid black with just levels in Photoshop. And then next week's stream, I'll be coloring this. So usually when I do my penciling, it's a little faster than my coloring because I tend to do my midtones, my flatting, and my highlighting in one solid stream. So that takes a bit longer. So like coloring streams will be like, I don't know, 5 hours, 4.5 hours. And usually like penciling a page that I've already blue lined will take like 2.5 hours or so. So this won't be an incredibly long stream. And I am working with a new setup here. So now I have my webcam like pretty much right above my art, which is great for visibility. However, that also means you might be seeing like the side of my head, you know, as I lean down to draw. So, you know, anyone in the chat, just feel free to like be like, hey, Draco, I can't see your art. I'm seeing the back of your head. It's lame. Stop. And I'll adjust. And if anyone is watching this and you're not logged in, please log in. It's super simple. You can register with your Facebook credentials. So if you're logged in one window or one tab into Facebook, in a separate tab, you can log in to... Rogue is hosting. Thank you, Rogue. That's awesome. I really appreciate it. How are you today? Oh yeah, so I was just in the middle of saying, if you want to log in and you're not sure how, if you're logged in another tab or window in Facebook, you can log into Twitch with your Facebook credentials. You can just hit the Join Twitch button and register through Facebook, and then you'll be able to chat. And the chat is cool because it gives me something to respond to, so I'm not just rambling, not just talking to myself, but I'm actually talking to you. I will see what you write, and then I can respond, and other viewers can see what you write, and sometimes, you know, viewers get into conversations with each other, and that's cool. So, strange, at my... Oh, rename card, sup, man? Yeah, weird. There's like a lag, shows up faster on Twitch than it does on my Unkart chat. LD Bean, haircut, yeah, thanks for noticing. Wow, it's like a party. Yeah, Bean, I was wondering it. Evan, I was expecting you to be streaming today. What? Gorbzy is hosting! Woo, Gorbzy! Yeah. Whoop! How's it going, guys? It's like all my favorite people are here. I'm a happy Draco right now. So, for some reason, my thing, you know, the thing that shows viewers is showing no viewers, but I see a bunch of you in my chat taking a break to work on Society 6 stuff. Cool, I actually just started a Society 6 the other day after talking to you about it. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. I've been checking that out, figuring it out, doping around with it. It's pretty neat. I wish that it offered some of the products that Zazzle offers, like pins and buttons and, you know, like just like cheaper swag that's like easier for people to be like, yeah, I'll buy a button, you know. But it does seem like the products that Zazzle does offer are much better quality, and I mean, the products that Society 6 offers are much better quality. I like their uploader a lot better. I like their shop a lot better. I generally like Society 6 a lot better. So I noticed they have that all over print, or all over shirt print, and I was like, oh man, Bean's jellyfish would be so dope on an all-over print shirt, like starting like with the bottom of the page, the bottom of the tentacles being at like the bottom hem of the shirt, and like the jellyfish coming up to like, you know, just so its cap is like right over your heart area. Like, it'd be really cool. And, like, when I saw that, that's what I thought of. awesome jellyfish. I wasn't kidding. I really would buy that if you put it up. I would buy that shirt. Not the best, but it's something. Yeah, no, it's better than Jayel Starlove. Aww. Also, I am not wearing my glasses, so it's really hard for me to read this, but it's really hard for me to draw with my glasses on. It's strange. I don't expect anyone to understand. I'll work on it. Jayel Draco! They're drakes! Is that like a, that's a Frosted Flakes reference, right? They're great. Jayel Draco! Gorbzy, I can't hear your voice. So I can't hear you say Jayel Draco. I'm not gonna try. I'll just sound horrible. What I need to do is get a recording of Gorbzy saying it and just make it a command, right? So like, maybe I'll make it a user-specific command that only Gorbzy can use. So he can just be like, whatever, hit exclamation mark Jayel Draco, and then it'll say it in his voice. That would be so cool. Jayel Draco. Draco. Lost twin sister, is that you? Did you guys get lost when you were riding around on me when I was a tiger? That time? Fond memories of that. Rename card, what are you up to? There's like, wait, is my music not playing? It's just really low, huh? Can you guys hear it? Oh yeah, there we go. It's the Wind Waker Symphony. Sounds really weird when you say we were riding you, Kappa. Yeah, well, you know. I've never claimed not to be really weird. I don't think. And if I did, I was probably being sarcastic. This page that I'm working on is hinting at Tracy's breaking point. She starts off all sad and then gets all like empowered and angry and then get scared because there's a thump coming from the secret passageway that leads to her grandfather's warehouse that her apartment is a front for and that she is sworn to protect. Kind of raised into it. It's not really her jam, and her boyfriend just broke up with her because he found out about her connections to an international crime syndicate. So she's super pissed. She's like, everything in my life sucks. She's all pissed off. Poor Tracy. And she hears a thump coming from the secret passageway to the secret warehouse. And what she finds there will change her life forever. Oh my. I love this song. I kind of love all of the Legend of Zelda songs. Well, don't go work at an international crime network then. Well, she was born into it, right? So like, she's kind of never really even thought that she had a choice. Until the page after this page. Well, maybe a couple pages after that. I mean, it's a process, you know. Don't go being born into an international crime syndicate. You should pick your biological parents better, damn it. So, Bean, does that mean that you have new stuff up on Society 6? I'm gonna go check it out, but not right now, because I'm streaming, obviously. Okay, guys, please stand by while I go do some, online browsing. But we got a nice mod wall going on.
Wall of mods!
Almost. Oh no, who's not a mod? Took forever to scan everything. Oh yeah, yeah. Now I'm editing and uploading. That's the fun part, right? No, the fun part is making the art. Everything else is just like pulling teeth, right? But you gotta do it so that you can keep making art. When you feel like giving up and you just can't possibly, like, you know, set up another thing and like do another thing and promote another thing and make another product and blah blah blah, just let music like this be your like soundtrack. Like, it's this heroic task every time you do it, you know, because it kind of is, right? Like, doing that is a way of like making your art sustainable, and making your art sustainable means that you'll be able to continue focusing on your art and putting more art into the world. And I mean, what could be more heroic than that, right? I mean, unless you're rich, which if you are, like, cool, but, you know, or like have some kind of circumstance where you're just able to do it, that's awesome. But I mean, you know, if you're not, then you just have to do what you have to do, and that's just how it is. But I think even, like, you know, even if you have everything that you want going for you, if you want your art to be out in the world, you have to, like, keep making the products, keep doing the streaming, keep doing the Facebook, keep doing the Twitter, keep doing all of the things. But the streaming is fun. Music is good, yay! I love it. Yes. Yes, this is the soundtrack, the heroic soundtrack. Make your Zazzle uploading, or fuck, Society 6 uploading and editing and all that, your Twittering and whatever, you know, make it all just hero tasks, like quests. Like, pretend Twitter's a dungeon, you know, and you have to like defeat the boss by like saying the perfect thing in 140 characters or less, you know, or whatever, I don't know. When the thing tells you you're out of characters. Maybe it's 140. Maybe it's 120. So our makeup is all like running from crying. But then like in the last panel, kind of using it as like it becomes her war paint, basically. And that's, you know, totally like intentional symbolism, because what drives her to be so, to become so empowered as her character does, is how upset she is about this whole situation and feeling, you know, just born into a life of servitude and powerlessness and, you know, just kind of being, you know, in her own way, just being oppressed from day one, you know. So I think, like, all of that emotion becoming her, you know, her fuel also, like, lends itself to the symbolism of her teary, smudgy makeup being her war paint. I don't know, sounded good in my head. Sometimes I just say things. I don't always know if it's gonna mean stuff or not. This webcam is like, God, right in my head. Right in my eye. Damien Smith. Heyo. How's it going?
What's happening, guys?
It's a party.
Party at my place.
I feel so honored y'all could be watching the debate right now. Nightbot, you're slow. What? Nightbot just welcomed you? Lamebot. That Jayel is the dude 2.0? What does that mean? Like, the dude? Nightbot, are you telling me you've forgotten me already? Ah, Damien. That clown show. Yeah, really, that clown show. But so many people are just into clown shows, man. Dean gets it. All you get it. Isn't the dude. Dude abides, man. So, well, Damien, that's really quite a compliment, I think, and I'm not sure if I can live up to it. Because, like, the dude is the dude, man, and I can't... I don't know, I'm just like a guy. Nah, that's too, like, gender binary. I'm just, like, an earthling, man. I don't know if I'm cool enough to be the dude 2.0. Unless, like, maybe you think the dude is lame, and that's why you're calling me the dude 2.0, because you're like, Jayel Draco is lame bot. I'm sorry. I'm just... rambling. So I deleted my entire OBS this morning when I was like making sure things were working right and setting up for my stream. I wanted to put in like a new scene for when I'm taking a break, you know, like a little BRB scene. Need some white Russians all around. Dude is cool. I did it. Are you happy? You made me do it. The Gorbsy made me do it. That's gonna be my epitaph. The Gorbsy made me do it. So I realized some of this music is, like, recorded at different levels, and I wish that I knew how to, like, have my media player, like, auto-gain control the levels, but I don't. So some songs might just start coming on blasting, like, way louder than the previous song. Feel free to tell me to adjust my volume. I want your experience with this stream to be as positive as I can make it. course, it's my fault. Blame Gorbzy. The Gorbzy made me do it. It could be a good thing. Maybe, like, I do something really, really heroic, like, I don't know, uploading all the things to the place, you know? And then I, like, you know, John Henry Irons style, like, blow a blood vessel while doing it, and it was, like, my awesome last accomplishment in life. And I was like, the Gorbzy made me do it. You know, and it was like awesome, and everyone was like, "Woo, dude! I like the arm in the first panel." Oh, thanks, man. The up arm or the around the chest arm? Because I feel like, or around the belly arm. I feel like I like her forearm here. Maybe her upper arm is okay, but I was really freaking struggling with this. It was hard, man. Art is freaking hard. Yeah, so I don't know if you guys can see, but this is my original, like, at-size sketch. And before that, I did a little, like, thumbnail sketch. So, you know, I always, like, rework this stuff, like, again and again to kind of figure out all the things that need figuring out. Snags and... Also, my webcam is on a new... arm, so I'm still getting used to the idea that it's like right here. So if I'm like this and you guys are like, oh god, it's Jayel's ear, oh, his sideburn, it's too big, ah, like, you know, you can tell me. I won't be offended. I'll just try to inch over. I mean, unless you're a jerk about it, then I'll cry. And everyone will know that you made me cry, and then people will be like, psh, you're that dude that made the dude 2.0 cry. I can't call myself that. I'll happily let someone else call me that, but I feel like a poser if I call myself that. So I don't know how well you guys can see this, what I'm doing, but so I actually took this drawing that I did and I scanned it and then, you know, made it very, very light and cyan and printed it out large. So those are my blue lines are actually taking my scan of my original drawing. And now I'm just doing like a much more like detail-oriented, focused rendition of it. It'll be sharper lines and, you know, because this will be reduced, so all my funky little pencil notches and weird things that happen for some reason won't be visible. Or at least as visible. I mean, unless I really screw up. Then I'll be taking it into Photoshop anyway, so... Ah, my nose! Seeing the side of my nose, I don't like it. Thank you. Bean, did you try Redbubble, or you were just saying that you knew other people that had... It's Redbubble, right? That's a printing art thing, like Society 6. So what I'm doing is really hard lines, and I F up my fine point electric eraser handy, because sometimes, you know, when you have a heavy hand like me and you just like grind your pencil into the page, the only way to like erase that is like with precision instruments. Some people are like, dude, you just shouldn't draw so hard. And I'm like, F that, draw hard or go home. No, I'm not really like that. I just can't help it. It won't help. I don't help it. Red bubble, 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 butt. Yes, red bubble. I know someone that uses it, and I'm pretty sure they have things like stickers and buttons. Woo! So, yeah, if it, like, works as well as Society 6, but has, like, the kinds of products that, like, Zazzle offers, then I'm all about it. Because I was kind of like, man, if there was only something in between Zazzle and Society 6. Now, this is serious heroing music. So yeah, they do have stickers. Sweet. Awesome. Make that graphite. That. And nope. Okay, cool. Reload my pencil during a stream? Psh, what am I, an amateur? Amateur hour up at Jayel Draco's channel. And it looks like you can set the price of the t-shirts and everything. With S6, you can only customize the pricing for the prints. Right. Yeah, that was the other thing that I noticed. Like, you can't. There's a lot of things that you can't really alter that much. The thing that really bothers me about Zazzle is, as a user, when you're going, like, if someone goes to my store to buy something of mine because, whatever, maybe they're friends or family and they just want to be supportive, it's so easy for them to end up, like, browsing into a product on someone else's store and not even realize that they're buying something that has nothing to do with me. It's, like, kind of lame. And I mean, you know, that's cool. Like, if someone wants to just shop around on Zazzle and get other things, that's cool. But, like, if someone is specifically there to buy something from a specific artist and they end up buying someone else's stuff and don't even realize it, you know, like, that's kind of... Like, they're not... The shops are not as personal, you know? So that was kind of, like, an annoying thing about it, I thought. And I felt like Society 6 was a little bit better about, like, your store looking like your own sectioned off store, you know? So, like, whatever, if your, like, mom or something is gonna buy something from you, like, she knows she's actually buying it from you. Just as a weird example, but... I mean, I have this friend, right, whose mom wanted to buy something from them. No, I'm just kidding. My mom has not bought anything from my Dazzle store, I don't think. Maybe she did. Actually, no, once she bought a skateboard with some art that I made for my brother from my store. It was cool. That was the thing. So, yeah, on Zazzle, like, they had really cool products. Like, you could make, like, skateboards and, like, all kinds of stuff. But, man, their service is just so crappy. I've had, like, products removed because the... I don't know, like, keywords or something were, like, related to something that was trademarked. And, like, they didn't even tell me. And they leave the products up in your store... And then when someone goes to buy them, they just can't. And it's like, what? You guys should, like, send out an email or something at least and, you know, like, look into it before, like, disabling someone's product. But it's all automated, you know? Like, they don't actually look at anyone's store. They just have, you know, bots just do their thing. And, I mean, these are, like, nightbot quality bots, you know? They're not, like, very sophisticated. Yeah, Society 6 is pretty chill about that. Now I'm curious about Redbubble stores. That'll be my next venture. And I mean, you know, I'll leave up my stuff that I have on Zazzle on Zazzle. And if I do decide to make a Redbubble store and use that instead, like, and put that as the link on my website for Oneshi Press, I'll still keep the Society 6 store up just in case anyone stumbles upon it, but I'm trying to kind of make an educated decision here. But really, it takes so friggin' long to, like, have a shop set up to the point where you know if you like it or not. I spent a lot of time on my Society 6 store already, and I'm still not even certain about it. Oh, just do all the things! With hero music in the background. Nightbait. It's not very original, Trumpa. You should probably spend more time on your insults. Tracy Queen has famously long, tangly, curly hair. It's really friggin' hard to draw. But I guess it's also really fun to draw, so whatever. So, anybody got a joke? And if anyone wants me to, like, zoom in or change my webcam or anything, feel free to request. I know you all are digging my hot pink triangle. Is my little chat thing working? My chat box? Like, can you see it on my stream, the last thing that someone said? Pop-up chat, whatever you want to call it. Gosh, I wish I knew what things were called. It would make Googling them so much easier. Test to see if the chat box worked. I wasn't looking. I always just describe it in the best way possible. Did you see it work? Yep. Alright, I saw it work. Woo! I saw it work for me anyway. What if it only works for me?
Walk down the store and I think
try something. I don't know if this is gonna work. Something I just tried to set up, like. What is it? Basically the same idea as Harvest. I just changed the language to suit my own weird little narrative. Because I'm a weird little narrative type of person. It's my thing, it's what I do. Faces are hard. But not when you have music like this playing. It's like, yeah, draw that tiny face. Do it. For great justice, draw the tiny face. And draw it quickly. The tempo commands it. Extend their freshly sharpened claws before approaching the anti-drake bunker. Nice. I got 31 of my own coins. Give what's Caesar to Caesar, baby. Thank you. I also just finished a first acrylic painting that I've done a long time. I don't know, a couple years. I mean, I like paint acrylic things all the time. Like, I paint sculptures and, you know, parts for costumes and props. You know, but that's like trying to take something that I made in clay and paint it to look like stone or like bone or, you know, things like that. Or like painting material to make it look distressed. Whereas like doing an actual proper, like, painting is a completely different story. I'm tempted to show it on my stream, but there's some artistic, mild artistic nudity in it. We all know that the female nipple is evil, and if people see it, their eyes might explode out of their heads, and people will get pregnant and give birth to demons on the streets, and, you know, God knows what'll happen if they see a nipple. So I'm kind of feeling like maybe I shouldn't show you guys. Unless someone's like, nah, it's totally cool, you can have mild artistic nudity on Twitch, it's fine. But I don't trust my own judgment enough about those things, so I tend to err on the side of caution, as I've been advised to. Alright, now the surprised face. After she hears the thump on the door while acting all hardcore, she's like, I'm so hardcore, and then there's a thump and she's like, what the fuck? Not necessarily because she's afraid of the thump, but she's more afraid of her grandfather finding out that she let someone break into the warehouse. She is a trained warrior, so she's definitely not afraid of, like, going down there and finding out that there's some, you know, criminal down there. She'll just dice the criminal, but then her grandfather will be like, you let someone in, blah, blah, blah. Cranky old man stuff to say, blah, blah, blah. And she'll be like, that's just, like, your opinion, man. This is looking nice. Thanks, Bean. I have to AFK for a bit, though. I'll be in and out. Cool. Well, thank you so much for stopping by. I hope I get to see your chatty, texty stuffs before my stream is done. But if not, thanks for popping by. I always appreciate your presence. Just learned what AFK means. It was actually Bean that told me. Someone was like, I have to AFK, and I was like, that sounds sick, what does that mean? And Bean was like, away from keyboard, and I was like, Now I feel all, like, leveled up in my knowledge. Know things now. Things you wouldn't believe. So, like, trying to get perspective, right, on, like, open mouth facial expressions, like, three-quarter, like, someone gasping or something. It's just so freaking annoying. How do people do this shit? I worked for the artist Neil Adams for many years, and one thing that Neil's certainly known for, and there's, you know, mixed reviews on it, like some people say maybe he took it a little far sometimes, but one thing he always did was, like, in almost every panel, when someone's talking, like, he'll have their mouth open in one of the actual phonemes that they're saying in that panel. So, like, if they're saying, like, I'm gonna kick your ass, you might make them, like, you know, or something like that, or whatever. But, man, like, in, like, half a second, he can draw any phoneme or expression from, like, any angle. Yeah, I think one of the critiques of that that I've heard is just that after doing, like, a lot of more, like, animatic commercial work for many years, I think a lot of his stuff tended to be, like, kind of a little more family-friendly and a little more, like, cartoony than it used to be. So I think, like, he kind of took it a little bit to an extreme of, like, just always having people, like, you know, making faces. But whether you like it or not, I mean, it's still, like, something that he's really good at that a lot of people are not really good at. Just being able to draw, like, a mouth in a weird pose from a weird angle. And whether you think that that should be the drawing in that panel or not, being able to draw it is still freaking impressive. So, yeah, I'm trying to, like, you know, remember the lessons that I've gleaned from studying his art up close and watching him work on it, and, you know, and some key advice that he's given me, and, you know, things that he said, but he was really much more of a visual person, I think. For me, anyway, what I got out of him was more visual. But also, I was an employee, so he didn't really have time to, like, hold my hand and talk to me. Like, he had me doing stuff all the time, so a lot of what I learned there was from what I had to do, and a lot of it was, like, you know, doing stuff in After Effects or Photoshop to his art, so I got to study a lot of his art. Anyway, I'm totally rambling now. Someone give me something to talk about, or I'll just keep rambling. I swear, I'll do it. I'll keep rambling. I think I won't. Unless you guys like me rambling, I mean, that's weird. Maybe you do. That's cool. Maybe I'm better at rambling than I think. this song. Definitely feel like I'm being abducted while camping in the woods every time I hear this song. Abducted by aliens, not by, like, I don't know, bad guys. If anyone has any good hair advice, I'm all ears, cause hair is freaking hard, man. Or like, can point to a good reference or tutorial that they use or whatever. Didn't come out as bad as I was afraid of. Still freaking weird. Could be worse. I could be like utterly ashamed of it. Okay, I think I'm going to take a quick break before finishing the rest of this page. You guys will bear with me for 5 minutes. I'm going to pause my music and switch my screen out. And I will be right back. The chat is still open. You can continue to chat, just not with me until...
Hi, I'm Lindsay G. I am the writer, editor, and co-founder of Oneshi Press.
Actually, can
Hi,
tell me...
Hi, Jayel Draco here, illustrator, right designer, and co-founder of Oneshi Press.
Oneshi Press is an independent publisher of books in print and digital formats.
Supported by people like yourself.
Right now, we have a graphic novel, a comic book, and an art book all in the works.
Oneshi Press offers you unique realities that you can't find elsewhere.
Oneshi Press aims to create vibrant, living, breathing worlds and invites readers into those worlds to explore.
Our current goal at Oneshi Press is to keep 3 projects in rotation at all times.
Oneshi Press is currently working on 3 projects. The first one is Tracy Queen.
Tracy Queen is a whip-smart, gonzo,
sex-positive, feminist porn star. She funds her own way and makes her own way through the world, but she has a background in organized crime. As she gains notoriety through her career, she earns a lot of powerful enemies in different sectors and decides that she needs to protect herself. With the help of her super genius electrical engineer raccoon best friend Nicola, she creates an army of cyborg clones using genetic samples that she collects on the sets of her adult films.
She's badass, she's in control, and she's taking matters into her own hands.
The Great Nations of Rendaria is our first large-scale art book.
Written and illustrated from the perspective of Jan Kazian. a character from the greater story, the Children of Gaia. In this fantasy world, the six great nations have since been destroyed.
All six of these great nations have mysteriously fallen, and now the scholar monk Jankasian is trying to preserve their memory in a tome.
Jankasian's goal is to keep their cultural histories alive with hope that it might lend aim to a budding future.
It's a really beautiful and epic book that takes place within the larger framework of the greater story, Children of Gaia. In Pack, Oneshi's first comic book outing, you can join Patience and his Dogs of Virtue
as they put crime under the fang.
They prowl the streets of Brooklyn at night,
looking for corruption. And where they find it, they dispatch their own brand of justice.
There's Patience, a broken man living on the edge with his pack. Diligence, the orphaned Eastern Wolf. Chastity, the exploited Tibetan Mastiff. Kindness, the abused Pitbull Terrier. Temperance, the experimental Blue Dane. Liberty, the seasoned German Shepherd. And Humility, the abandoned Mutt. Once you've heard their stories, you'll see things from their perspective.
But at what point of taking the law into your own hands does one become the villain?
All three of these huge projects have been in the works for years. My co-founder, Jayel Draco, and I used to spend our days working at our 9-to-5s and our evenings and weekends working on these projects. But as they continued to build, we realized that they were way too important to us for us to keep them on the back burner.
Creating worlds is no small endeavor. These projects are big, and we need your support to get them done.
So we've decided to launch a Patreon page. Patreon is a subscription service by which you can donate small or large amounts of money, if you want to, on a monthly repeating basis, thereby making what we're doing scalable. So if we're making a small amount of money, we can put out a small amount of materials to our loyal followers. But the more people that get involved and the more that they can donate, the faster we will be able to make the production of these projects happen.
We need funding. No amount is too small. The more funding we get, the more we can get done.
Oneshi Press aims to have at least three projects going at any given time. As soon as one project is completed, we'll put another one into the roster and keep it rolling.
These projects will have snippets released in turn, one after the other, on a rotational basis.
We hope that we'll be able to finish all of our projects this way, and eventually we would love to open it up so that we can publish works by other people as well.
To find out more about us, our projects, and our growing team, visit OneshiPress.com.
Many of our projects have their own websites as well.
Through our website, OneshiPress.com, you can find out more about each individual project, and there's links to those projects' websites.
Tracy Queen actually has her own website with a blog, and her own Tumblr, and Twitter, and Facebook.
To help support Oneshi Press, visit our Patreon campaign at patreon.com/OneshiPress.
On our Patreon page, you can pledge whatever amount you're able to and sign up for a whole variety of really great rewards, ranging from access to our private members-only Patreon feed to exclusive behind-the-scenes artwork and information, ranging the whole way up to custom-made artwork, stories, and more from your favorite characters.
At Oneshi Press, we build worlds, and you're invited.
Support our Patreon if you can, but if you can't, we'd still love it if you could like our stuff on social media, share it, tell your friends about it, get everybody involved.
Thank you so much for your support. And remember, every like, share, and comment on social media actually boosts our signal, and that helps too.
Thanks for your support. The music you're hearing is by Jack Shell, thesoundweaver.com.
Something else that I wanted to do, and I can't remember what it is, and I wrote it, maybe.
Damn it! Okay. And I f***ed it up. Damn it! I was doing so... A lot, I can't do this. I'm sorry, it was terrible.
That's fine.
No. Alright! Hi, I'm Lindsay G. I am the writer, editor, and co-founder of Oneshi Press.
Hi, Jayel Draco here, illustrator, designer, and co-founder of Oneshi Press.
Oneshi Press is an independent publisher of books in print and digital formats.
Supported by people like yourself.
Right now, we have a graphic novel, a comic book, and an art book all in the works.
Oneshi Press offers you unique realities that you can't find elsewhere.
Oneshi Press aims to create vibrant, living, breathing worlds and invites readers into those worlds to explore.
Our current goal at Oneshi Press is to keep 3 projects in rotation at all times.
Oneshi Press is currently working on 3 projects. The first one is Tracy Queen.
Tracy Queen is a whip-smart, gonzo,
sex-positive, feminist porn star. She funds her own way and makes her own way through the world, but she has a background in organized crime. As she gains notoriety through her career, she earns a lot of powerful enemies in different sectors and decides that she needs to protect herself.
Okay. Ads once. Alright, yeah, I'll set that not to loop. I thought I would be back before it was done. I guess I just didn't time it so well. Sorry, Damien. Don't hate me forever. Just hate me for a few minutes and then get over it. Or something. Cool down. I don't know. Alright, hate me as long as you have to. I can take it. Yeah, I actually, until today, I just had like a little piece of paper that said I'll be right back that I put over my drawing, and that was kind of lame. So this is my first time messing with having a video play as my OA screen. So I gotta figure out how to make it not loop or have it switch to something different when that's done. That was our first Oneshi Press video. We're working on second one now, which is gonna be a lot better and a lot cooler and more entertaining and less, you know, blah blah blah, this is what we're doing, blah blah blah, you know, kind of lame. But you know, first time making a video to promote something you're working on. In that case, it was cool or different. Yeah, I mean, you know, better than a piece of paper, right? But I will, you know, I'm gonna tweak it. My goal has been and will continue to be to do something like to just make my stream a little better every week. And that means a lot of experimenting, and that means a lot of failing. you know, sometimes I think something is going to be better, and it's just not better. It's just worse. You know, I want it to be better in, like, a unique way, like something that I made, something that I did, something that's, you know, not common, not everywhere, you know, not something everyone's doing. So again, it's a lot of trial and error. I can apologize for my failures, but I'll never apologize for trying. I have never seen a proper ad within a stream. Never seen a proper ad. Meaning, like, ads within streams just are an improper thing to do. Like, it's just not proper. Or is that not what you meant? Maybe you just meant, like, people don't do them right. Up until today, I didn't even realize you could play a video in a stream. I looked into it and had to download an OBS plugin. And I was just excited that I got that to work without breaking stuff. Now, let me put on some music. But I forgot most of the stuff that was already in it, so maybe that was just me, or you need to end that video with a link so that people have time to look it up. And most of the time, you see ads that refer to social media and that same old stuff, but this was a proper ad. Oh. Cool. Thanks. It's late, my choice of words are less than perfect. No, thank you, I really appreciate that. Yeah. I could figure out maybe a way to have a link pop up at the end, or actually I don't know how to have a link, like a live clickable link in a stream. I don't know if that's possible. I guess that'll be something I'll have to look up. But yeah, and I'll definitely have it not loop, and I'm definitely gonna try to have a new video done soon that'll be more like entertaining and less like addy. But yeah, I mean, the whole point of this stream, like when I first started it, it was, the idea is like I'm only gonna be streaming things from our Oneshi Press projects mostly. I mean, except for like the occasional, you know, just impromptu stream. But all these projects are like our Oneshi Press projects, and our Patreon supporters, you know, like that, what we get from Patreon also is supporting the stream. Like each time I, you know, have to get a new piece of equipment, like this webcam and that mic and this webcam arm, all of those things came from Patreon support. So, you know, I feel like I want to try and like also draw some attention to that in the stream. You know, make sure that the people that are supporting us are like, oh cool, yeah, like that's what we're supporting, awesome, you know, like that they're aware that they're actually doing good and that we're doing good with the good they're doing stuff and things. Bunch of notifications. Hope everything is okay. Maybe it's all BS. Yeah, everything's okay. Yeah, man, advertising is hard, like talking about your own stuff. It's like, there's no way to do that and not just feel like a total, I don't know, like, dumb butt. Hence all those bloopers at the end. As far as I know, you can't have a clickable link within the stream, except for chat. But if you would have the link to the site just sitting there, people who are interested can type that link into their search bar. Okay, cool. So like, after the video is done playing, just have like the video disappear and just a link just kind of there, like the text link. Cool, that's a cool idea, thank you. I'm gonna do that.
You know, actually...
Oh, I can't edit it while I'm in this scene. But I know that I can edit it so that the video does not loop. Pretty sure I remember seeing that option in the plugin. Also, my entire computer desk right now, and actually for the last couple of years, is a folding table. So every time I move, it's an earthquake. And that's really annoying, I'm sure, and I'm sorry. When I can get a real table, I will. Or like desk or something. Well, after that rant, I'm gonna go back into the shadows of lurking. Aww. But I appreciate the rant. It makes me not the only one rambling and ranting and, you know, like, that was actually a really pleasant rant, if you can even call it a rant. I liked it. But feel free to lurk. Lurk, lurk, lurk. And thank you for the advice. I really appreciate it. I feel like the more that people give me their feedback on what I can do to make it better, like, the better I can make it, and that's win-win, right? Everybody wins! Last panel. Thank you. Here Tracy is grabbing her wakizashi off of her living room coffee table. It's intentionally cut off in the panel so that you can't tell it's a wakizashi. I want to go for... I think the assumption would be that it's a katana, right? Because, like, that's what people use, right? It's a katana. But actually, a katana is truly more of an outdoor weapon. If you were indoors, the wakizashi would be the proper choice. But also, like, Tracy is kind of small in stature. I think for her, using a wakizashi just kind of makes sense. And her sidekick, Nicola, who's a raccoon, he uses a tanto, which is like a dagger size version of the katana. Well, in this set, it would be a katana, a wakizashi, and a dagger, which is a tanto. So because he's a raccoon, the tanto is actually like the size of wakizashi, at least, in his hand, which I think is kind of funny. When I draw, it's like a fucking earthquake. Everything shakes and rattles and rolls. Thank you. just Tracy Queen getting her wakasashi. The music is feeling right. Have to kick some ass. Just about done here.
Well, I walk, let me be, don't you bump into me. Tell me why, tell me why, tell me why. Is everybody so, so tired?
All right, so I think I'm going to conclude this with a little zoom in. I'll just use my webcam controller here. Zoom in and move around on the page to show you all what I've done tonight. So, panel one is, again, it's a wall of text behind Tracy. She's thinking to herself, never asked for this family, tradition, duty, grandfather's legacy, 6 months of fucking me, and he runs when he learns the truth, calls me a common criminal. She's talking about, you know, the two things that are really effing up her life right now, her grandfather forcing her into this organized crime life, and then her boyfriend who just broke up with her, and it's kind of like just one in many failed relationships because of her life, her lifestyle, that really she perceives herself as not having had a choice about. So then the next panel, The next panel is her, you know, finding resolve, and she's saying, there's nothing common about me. She's all like pissed off and finding some strength in her anger, you know, sadness has subsided to anger. So here she's all standing strong and tall and angry, and she's just, you know, ready to like take life by the cojones, and then there's a thump coming from the door, and this door leads to her bedroom, and within her bedroom it's a closet door, and inside her closet is a doorway to a secret stairwell that leads to her grandfather's warehouse. So she hears a thump coming through the door, and she whips around and is like, oh crap, you know, like there's a noise, like that's definitely not good, because this is definitely a kind of situation that people should not know about. So then going down to this panel, she whips around to the door, and she's muttering, there's still sounds coming from the doorway, like rustle, rustle. She's muttering, shit, grandfather's gonna kill me. So she turns around and she grabs her wakizashi and continues saying, if there's someone in the warehouse. So this is her grabbing her wakizashi. Looks a little blurry. Well, anyway, so that's my stream for tonight. I hope you all enjoyed it. I certainly did. Thanks so much to everyone who stopped by. It was great seeing you all, hearing from you, whatever. So until next time, be well, safe and swift. Talk to you later.